So we're staying at Broome, the Pistol Club. Whoop, just get out of the way. Yeah, we're staying at the Pistol Club. It's been a good base. You're only allowed to stay there for 7 nights, but we'll make the most of that. Because after the Gibb, we're all wrecked, so we had 2 days of doing not too much. And our friends we met on the Gibb, they've messaged us this morning and said they're at a place called Coconut Well. I hadn't heard of it. We hadn't done a lot of research yet as to what we're going to do around here, but it's only 25 minutes up the road from the Pistol Club. I don't know if there's coconuts here, buddy. But driving in, it looks pretty bloody specky. So the very end of the road is a four-wheel drive only track, so we're obviously going to make the most of that and do less walking. And let's go and check it out.
Doesn't matter how many times we come to the beach here, you just do not get used to the colour of the water. I don't know if it looks better through my sunnies, but it's crazy. And looking at these rock pools, we need some shoes. And also, it's kind of low tide. I think, by the sounds of it, it's probably better closer to high tide. We might have to come back yet. It's still such a cool place. Short girl, big car problems. Oh, I get stuck making the food all the time because you can't reach.
It's good because he doesn't make it in the van.
Whatever. Unreal, but I think we might have to move. Apparently up here they get like 8 meter tides and the tide is coming in hot. So when I drove down here, one thing I didn't consider was getting off the beach, right? So the drive down was fine, but I just watched two blokes leave here and one of them punched it and he was fine and the other one got bogged. So it's gonna be interesting because that was a Hilux that weighs probably 2.5 ton, or 5 ton. And I haven't, as of yet, let any air out, and I don't want to. I'm being lazy, but I just don't want to do it. See how we go. See what happens. I don't even want to leave. Look at this joint.
As I said before, the tide's coming in. We've been down the beach for quite a few hours now, and kids are getting a little bit tired, so it's time for us to go. Now, Lindsay has to attempt to get up here. It looks like a bit of a wild ride. We'll see how he goes. Following the other people's tracks this time. Here he goes, slow, slow. And he's up. Yeah, this rock edge here goes real soft. And this rock edge quite here. But made that one look easy second go anyway.
Ended up at a place called Red Sand Beach. I don't know how, because we're looking for Roebuck Bay, and then somehow we ended up finding pictures of this place and thought we'd come for a drive. It's actually a bird sanctuary, or there is one around here somewhere. Got the red cliffs. And look at this. Look at these trees growing in the water. So come high tide, that'll look absolutely special. But colours even now are just crazy. So anyway, we're going to go and have a play around down there. Don't know if I could be bothered wandering out there for a fish, but we're allowed to fish here. There's good parking spots all the way along here. We just set up for a bit of lunch first, get the horn in out.
We picked the special purpose zone where you can actually fish here too.
Yeah, somehow. That water, so crazy. Oh. Turns out you can't walk very fast in here. Just saw, I think they're flying fish. I just saw a massive one. But it ducked back in underneath this mud. Oh, I'm going under. Look at these trees, it's gonna look so cool when they're underwater. Far out, so cool. So we're looking at all these little fish that were bloody trying to hide in the mud. And we're like, oh, what are they? Do you reckon they're flying fish or something?
We thought they were flying fish.
Yeah, they look like flying fish to us.
And our four-year-old ended up educating us on what they actually are. Eli, what were the fish in the water on the mud there?
Mud skippers. And he looks at us like, what do you mean you don't know they're mud skippers? Doesn't everyone know they're mud skippers? Oh, man. So I sort of used to hate the idea of them watching TV, but some of these shows I watch are really educational. Look at them all. I don't know if you can see them. I hope you can. They're everywhere. They're just skipping around. I'm half wondering if they wouldn't make some good bait. There's a big one over there. The water comes in that fast, you can sort of hear it rushing in. It is crazy.
It's the moment that we've been waiting for.
So we're going to be waiting all afternoon. It's only been an hour.
And it's been a good hour though.
Yeah.
If you come down, definitely spend a bit of time down here.
It is ridiculous. It's like just nothing like anything else we've seen. Trying to get some photos with the camera. Family shots, because we don't have any friends, so. Alright, this is what I've been waiting for.
We had this whole beach to ourselves, so there's no one around.
Have a go at it. Look. I don't know if you can see that. Looks pretty bloody cool with that tree. Anyway, let's try again. The other hard part is wrangling up the kids. Hey kids, do you want to take another photo?
No.
And just like that, the water's all the way up here. And it goes a lot further up. So they have like 8 meter tide, so looking at the red sand, it looks like it goes pretty far up near the cliffs. Which is crazy to think. Oh, they're out with a cast net. Kids are absolutely loving it now. The further away we walk, the prettier it gets when you turn around. It's just nuts. Anyway, that's Red Sand Beach. Literally been here for, we worked out just over an hour. Look at the change from when we got here. Well worth a visit, and it's a really crappy corrugated road in, so just keep that in mind. For probably 20 odd k's, I'd say at least.
This is Cable Beach.
Cable Beach, here we come. Couldn't leave Broome without doing a Cable Beach sunset, so here we are. It's already a heap of cars here, but there's the camels too. It's not often you gotta wait for camels to cross the road, especially on the beach. It's a nice looking beach too. How good is this, eh? You know what they say, when in Broome, you gotta come down here and get a photo with the camels. Yeah, buddy. This beach is wicked, it's so hard. Got some friends coming down later, so I'm trying to spread out a bit. Oh, I hate doing that. What do? You'd rather hang out with your friends than some people you're not going to talk to. Well, let's go have a look at the water. Come on, buddy! How's the temperature? Good? Oh, yeah, it's nice. Here, buddy, let's show her how it's done.
Mm-hmm. We set it up.
It's already on.
Yeah, I know. Well, there they go.
What a stitch up, mate. Look at that. They're just going around us. Hey, well, one last chance for a good photo, aren't they? Going around us. So there you have it, mate. Cable Beach. Camels on the beach. Where else do you see camels on the beach? Pretty bloody cool. This is the lineup for the Pistol Club. So the Pistol Club is an overflow, and yeah, come 8:30, there's a massive lineup out the front. Both times we've come, we've got in about 10, and pretty much roll straight in. So obviously that'll change day to day. We've been super lucky both times, getting the site and not having to wait in a massive lineup. So yeah, bit of Pistol Club intro.
Well, yesterday we got the last site, so we're very, very lucky.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe don't wait till 10.
I'm sure. All right, so we're back in Broome. We spent a week here and then we went up to the Dampier and now we're back. And something we missed last time we were here was Simpson's Beach. Turns out it's only 2 minutes down the road from the Pistol Club where we stayed last time, and we're staying there again. So let's go and check it out. Family are already down there. I had to chuck the drone up to have a look. Looks pretty bloody cool. See that sign every day? Hovercraft in use. That's it, eh? Simpson's Beach. Pretty cool. Worth a visit if you're staying at the Pistol Club, because it's only 2 minutes away. But yeah, we did prefer Red Sand Beach, but the road into Red Sand Beach is horrid. Yeah, and it's much further away. So.
Willie Creek Pearl Farm.
Well, this place looks pretty cool. The water is just something else again. I cannot believe the colour of this water. It is insane. So yeah, this is Willie Creek Pearl Farm. They got a cafe and stuff here too, and I saw a playground. So I'll take the kids over to that after we go and have a look down here. But yeah, the colour of this water is literally insane. Never seen anything quite like it. Probably can't see it real well. Oh, fishing. It is so clear, it's crazy. Isn't that just the craziest water you've ever seen? There's a playground here. Oh, look at it. And there's all these games too. I'm gonna smash you at knots and crosses.
Oh,
ring show. Knots and crosses. What are you playing, buddy? Jenga.
Whoa, right,
let's do it. Bit of, what do you call this again? Hack-a-sack. Sack-a-hack. What's it called?
Sack-a-hack? I don't know.
let's see what you got. Oh, that wasn't even close.
Well, I got it in the first time. I didn't have the camera out. Oh, got that one here.
Thank you.
No worries. Ta.
Good stuff.
You missed that too, just so you
can. Oh, you didn't get it in, don't you?
I did.
Go and do it on. You got it in, that's it. Yeah, see, I told you.
Oh! That one's light. There's nothing in it. Close.
Oh, nearly, buddy.
Oh. Is there more?
Alright, here we go. I'm gonna guess 4, I reckon.
Alright, I'm gonna guess. 2.
Oh, I'm gonna get that one in yet.
1.
Mom, I'm doing it.
Okay.
Let's go on in that one.
No.
They're both going in.
I'm gonna move it. It's cheating.
2.
Two.
That's the light one.
Hang on, I got one more. Oh, that wasn't too bad.
Bit of something for lunch. Looks pretty bloody good. Who else didn't know that pearl meat was a thing? Apparently, this is pearl meat.
Well, we could have lunch here.
It's not bad.
It's interesting.
Just, the marinade overpowers it, but I think maybe it needs it.
Yeah.
But it's nice.
Well, we're going to have like a calamari
yeah. Texture, yeah.
Daddy, were we going to have lunch here?
Well, we didn't really have a plan, buddy. We just take it as it comes. But now we are. This is just up the road from the cafe. Kids get to play in the sand. I get to fly the drone, and then I'm going to go fishing over there. It looks ridiculous. This is a perfect case of what my phone sees, what my drone sees. So just that you saw a huge fish, so the drone's going away. It's time to go fishing. Well, no luck in the fishing department. But yeah, anyway, I'm gonna quickly throw the drone. Is that some fish just there? I'm gonna quickly throw the drone up again, see if we can't see a croc before we go. And we'll head back to camp. It's bloody good spot, would recommend. There's also Wi-Fi at the shop too, we found, so. All in all, a bloody well worth a visit down here. Maybe I won't get the drone up.
That'd be so beautiful seeing.
Oh yeah. You can watch it from the sky when we get back to the camp. Cheaper than a chopper, right? That's for sure.
But when you break it all.
Yeah. Expensive hobby. Time to sort that out. Ah, it's better. Alright, so we're still in Broome, been here for ages it feels like. But coconut well. We're back here. I'll show you some other footage of it. It's really quite cool. But if you go over a 9 meter tide, you can actually float down. All this fills up with water apparently. I presume it's here. Fills up and you can float all the way back down to the car park. So
9.2 metre tide today, so we're going to go and give it a whirl, see what happens.
If anyone we've walked past wanted kids before they came, they don't now. Sienna's having a conniption over because she found some cuttlefish and Vanessa won't eat it. Eat this!
What do you reckon, buddy? Want to go float down the water that's not here? It's a big area to fill up. Look at it, it's huge. So apparently we walk all the way over there, and when the tide hits 9 meters, it'll rush in, and hopefully no crocs or sharks wash in, I suppose, and then we float down. Sounds bloody cool, mate.
Vanessa's gonna pass out because she's blown up the ring while she's walking.
Look how big of an area it is, right? It's all this, which is huge, and then all the way up there. You can see the water at the end.
Hey, this is cool. Something different.
So yeah, it's coconut well, or wells. Seen it said both ways. It's only like 25 minutes out of Darwin, and the road in is to this car park is pretty much all bitumen. So this only happens when it's 9 meter tide. So pretty lucky. The other thing I'm going to try and do tonight is the staircase to the moon. Again, that only happens once every, I don't know if it's every month, but it's a couple of days when it's a full moon and the moon rises over the beach. So I'll try and get a photo of that tonight and show you. We've watched a few people walk up with their clothes and towels and stuff, and they sort of get halfway up and then turn around and walk back. It's, you can't take anything, you leave it all at the car because you float back to your car. So keep that in mind if you're going, don't be one of those guys. Oh, this is so cool. You can actually see the water starting to trickle in. Here it is here. Yeah, well, so it just keeps rolling in until it fills it up. Oh, here we go, a couple of test dummies. How's the temp? Is it warm?
Yeah, mate.
Oh, it's so warm. It's actually warm. Oh, no, now it's cold.
Oh, no.
Oh, this is so good. It's really ripping fast. Yeah. It'll probably walk out of the water and make it a bit easier. Hey, mate, here you go. Puppy! This is a good angle to see how fast it's flowing. Have a look at it. The kid's excited? You excited?
Oh yeah. I'm looking forward to floating down.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome. Let's do it. Come at all these bubbles. Crazy. Pop, pop, pop. Probably see it a bit better from up here. Just another crazy beautiful beach. Oh, there's water on this side too. Have a go at it. Come on down!
Right on
that! Whoa! Come, baby! Okay. Step over the stick.
Over the stick. And then... Run, run, run!
Whoa! Wow! Watch the stick. I think we might have found a hack. Hey, instead of walking the rest of the way.
Careful, Bobby. Oh, it's so strong!
Eli, sit on my back, buddy. Here, Bubby. Jump on my back. Jump on my back. Jump on. Jan? Yeah, this is a great idea. So don't walk up the water.
I want it.
You're right. You just cross over to the beach and there's another little... You know, stay on, Bubby.
I want it.
Well, you're going to have to walk then. And you can just float down here too. Oh, good job. Let's catch up to Mummy. We got a little outboard over here. Oh, are we catching yet? So cool. Every time a wave comes in, it pushes a bit of water. Are you right, baby? Oh, nearly this capsized.
Is not big enough for two?
No, this one barely is.
You right, Bobby?
Yeah. You on, buddy?
Yeah.
Let's go. She's a bit of a slow boat, but we are moving.
Yeah,
I'm fine. Vanessa just saw some people through the gap in the sand, and we actually overtook some people by floating down here. Buddy, that's a hot tip for you, mate. That's awesome. All right, so here's the actual inlet. It's quite a walk, eh? It's probably a half hour walk, I'd reckon. So yeah, the tide must not break over this little bit here until it hits like roughly 9 meters. Current's hooking up this end. These kids are about to get swamped by water. So good. Let's do this. Where's the girls again? There they are. All right, we're off.
We're off and racing.
Right. You reckon, buddy? Comfy?
Yes, they're comfy.
Yes, that's a right idea. Got some bait.
Beats would be good.
Yeah. Yeah.
What'd you say, buddy?
Beats would be nice,
wouldn't it? Yeah.
Oh, this is so relaxing. I feel like it's gonna go by too quick.
Yeah. Oh, this is annoying with this selfie stick thing. I don't normally use it. Oh, it's so cool. Yeah, definitely worth the walk.
I hope there's no rocks.
Yeah. Pop the cheers, we'll be walking back.
Do you reckon there's rocks here?
It's a liner.
Yeah, where's the swim up bar?
Yeah, no. So we're missing.
Well, we think we might have timed it perfectly. We got here at 10 past 10. And the high tide was 11:50, Clara.
Yeah.
So, because you got to... The water flows in with the tide, so you don't want to be here at high tide because you'll miss it.
And you don't want to be walking in the water either.
Yeah.
So it's easier to walk up on the sand when the water hasn't quite come in yet, and then
Well, not quite as easy as floating down the other side, eh? Hey?
Yeah, that was so good.
Yeah. But yeah, anyway, hot tip. I'm getting the third degree now because I gave a hot tip. Eli's asking what's a cold tip and what's a warm tip.
And what's a hot tip?
What's a hot tip? Cleaning your room and being good to your parents, that is a hot tip. So, another hot tip, stay on the ocean side because we're over the other side, so I mean stay just over there. Because on this side there's all rocks everywhere. We didn't see any rocks walking up, hey?
No, we didn't.
There's stingrays everywhere.
They're just rocks, stingrays. Buddy.
It's deep
they're
in
rock
the middle.
Stingrays. Oh, yeah. Mate, I'm just full of hot tips today.
I'm dying.
Cold tips, warm tips.
Oh, Eli's sunbaking.
Having a dream. I might go to sleep.
Oh, that looks so cute.
It's cold.
How beautiful is the colour of this water?
Oh, rocks! Oh my god!
Oh no!
Oh my god!
Oh no, we could deflate here. Good and badly.
I don't know if you can see the rocks, but oh, there's a whole pile of rocks there.
Oh, I think my gut just hit one.
Oh, God.
So you literally float all the way back. Car's over there. Make sure you put sunscreen on. It goes for ages. But thankfully for us, people over here had some tunes. So we've got to listen to some beats on the way down too. Anyway, that is a bloody, very cool experience. I will get the drone out and just have a look, see if you can make sense of what's going on. We'll be right back.
Did you enjoy the water?
Yeah. Well, not when I fell off.
Not when you fell off? Why not? Was it cold? It wasn't too bad.
Did you like floating on Daddy's back?
How about you, Bobby? Did you have fun?
Yeah.
Good times.
I will.
How cool was that?
That was so good. I loved it. It was so fun.
It was, I don't know. It was easy. It worked out perfectly. All up, we worked out it was about 2 hours we've been here. So we walked up probably, everyone else said 45 minutes. Felt like about half an hour to me, but who really knows? And then you just float down for ages. It's bloody cool. Yeah, anyway, good times. We're going to leave Broome tomorrow, so we're going to go and get some last minute supplies and head down to Bun Hill. See you then. Bit of a late night mission, watching the staircase to the moon. It's pretty cool. Sienna's got the job of carrying the tripod back to the car. You doing a good job, baby?
Yeah.
Is it heavy? Is it heavy?
Yeah.
You're so strong. Well, the start of the day. I just woke up and we had no power. We had no power at all, no lights, nothing. Fridge was off. I don't know what's happened here. Did a bit of digging and I found a broken cable lug on one of the batteries. So I'll show you that, because that's could be catastrophe. Like if that was sitting there just rubbing slightly, sparking, that's how you could end up with a fire in your battery compartment. So yeah, anyway, I'll show you that. Gotta get that fixed this morning. I've got it temporarily going for now. And also had no water, because the water hose popped off outside. That happens way too often, eh? The actual hose comes out of the fitting. But anyway, someone thankfully has turned it off. So, bloody start to the day, mate. We're gonna have a well deserved coffee and then get into sorting these problems out, finding all those sparky in town so I can buy some cable, making a new loop up. Bloody hell. So, one of these lugs actually snapped off this.
It's scary.
How? It must be from all the corrugation.
Look at that. So, it's gotta be from vibration, but the weird thing is that, we woke up with no power, so it's happened, it's separated overnight, which is really strange. But anyway, I went down to the local auto sparky shop and they had basically a battery link kit. So same size cable as what's in here. And easy fix.
Done and dusted. To be honest, I didn't even think we'd be doing an episode on Broome, but there's so much to see and do there. It's I reckon we'll be back. That's really good.
Yeah, we loved it. It was beautiful.
Yeah, it's like another Darwin, you know, an unexpected, awesome place. So we're heading down to Barn Hill Station today, and then we're going to 80 Mile Beach for, it looks like, a few days, because people have raved about 80 Mile. And then Port Hedland, then down to Karajini. So not sure where the next one will be, but yeah, tune in. Probably Karajini, I'd say. Maybe a little bit of 80 Mile in there. See you on the next one. Thanks for tuning in.